and welcome back to my kitchen. In today's video, we are making water fufu from scratch. Guys, this cassava fufu is a fermented version. There is a video whereby I made the unfermented version of water fufu. You can go check it out. Or better still, I will put the link down below. Okay, guys. Here, cassava is left for 3 to 5 days to soften. Then it is grated. Okay, guys. But here today I left my cassava for 10 days. That is because in this part of Africa it's not as hot as in West Africa. In West Africa, we usually leave our cassava for 3 to 5 days to soften, to ferment and soften. But here in South Africa where we are, the climate is different. So I left my cassava for 10 days. And for those 10 days, guys, I was taking it in and out under the sun. You can see here, after peeling and washing my cassava, I did put it in this bucket. But later on, I did change because nothing was happening. Okay, guys. So I added bicarbonate of soda to my cassava. Some people put nail, some people put some herbs to make it soft. Okay, so I did seal it nicely. I also used a foil paper to seal it. Okay, guys. So to those who do not know cassava fufu is a staple food in many African countries. Okay, it is made from fermented cassava. Okay, guys, after you ferment the cassava, then you have to undergo another process, which is blending. Either you use a blender back home when the cassava is very soft, we just use a sieve to wash it. Okay, but when the cassava is not very soft, like soft, we use a blender or a food processor. Guys, today I will be using my hand blender to mill it. Okay, but before I mill it, after the 10 days fermentation process, I did wash it thoroughly. Okay, I discarded the fermented smelly water, then I rinsed it very well. Like you can see, my cassava is clean. Then I'm going ahead now to remove the inner. There is a woody substance in the middle of the cassava. I'm getting rid of that. Okay, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Thank you so much. If this is your first time visiting, I want to say you are welcome. Please show me some love. Go ahead and like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you are a return subscriber, I want to say welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for your unending support. Go ahead and continue to show me some love, okay? Give me a thumbs up. Do not forget to comment, okay? Tell me down below how you make your cassava fufu. You can see mine is not very soft. But I am going ahead because I cannot keep waiting. Okay, guys. So I will use my hand blender. You can use even a juicer if you have a juicer at home. Okay, guys. Another thing I want you guys to know is when you use a blender, it is going to blend it smoothly. So you will not need to undergo all this process that I am doing. Here you will see me using my hand blender, and after using my hand blender, I'm going ahead to wash it again in clean water to extract more chaffs from the cassava. Okay, guys, but the good thing is that at the end my fufu was very smooth and shiny. Okay, yes, stay tuned. I will not be talking much, guys. Just watch me as I do my work. Guys, this water fufu is a side dish to any protein-rich food. Guys, another advantages of fermenting your cassava is to get rid of any potential toxic compounds that can be found in cassava. You know that sometimes people eat cassava and it worries them, it makes them sick, okay? But when you ferment it, you know the fermentation process also involves some bacteria, okay? Yes. You know, any fermented food is very good for you because it adds probiotics into your body, okay? That cleans your gut, cleans your intestines, okay? So when you ferment your cassava, you are not only getting that fermented smell that you want from your fufu, it's also got healthy bacteria that are incorporated into it, which are good for your gut. guys, at this stage, you can go ahead and use a cheesecloth to squeeze out the excess water for your water fufu, and you can cook it like that. But I went ahead to wash it further. I think the reason is just because I was using the hand machine, okay? If you use the blender, I think your fufu will be very smooth. But I'm going ahead to wash it to take out the excess chaff from it. You can see how much chaff is left behind after I washed it, okay? The only good thing here is that my fufu will be very soft and smooth and shiny, okay guys? So you can see I am done, guys. I'm just going to transfer this into a large pot and I will cover it to settle for about 1 or 2 hours. The water will float on top and the water fufu will remain underneath the pot. Then I will discard the water on top. Then with the help of my muslin bag, I am going to extract the excess water. Then my water fufu will be ready. Okay guys, can see my muslin bag. I'm going to pour the water fufu inside my muslin bag. I will tie this up. I will secure it properly. By tomorrow morning, my water fufu will be ready. Okay guys, I'll see you tomorrow morning. Good morning guys. Now our water fufu has been drying overnight. Let's see how it looks, guys. I secured it with my pepper stone and my gym lift. Okay, now you can see my water fufu is very dry. There's no water left. Okay guys, so this will be all, guys. Our water fufu is ready. Water fufu, water fufu, water fufu. Whoa, water fufu. Guys, here we go. Just transfer that into a sealable dish. You can store this in the fridge for up to 6 months. Okay? Yes. Okay, guys. That will be all from me today, guys. Until I come your way next time with another recipe, stay healthy, stay safe. And please do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye.